Hi everyone, my name is Ali and in this video I'm going to share with you exactly how to use the ArriveCAN app. So if you're planning to travel to Canada, whether by air, land or a marine vessel, you should use this app and enter your information within 72 hours of your departure to Canada. Now let's go ahead and fill out this app together. So once you download the app and create an account, you will get to this page, so let's just click on continue. The next question you'll see is about how are you entering into Canada. Now, since most people travel by air, let's go ahead and for the purpose of this video, click on air. In the next step, you need to enter your flight details. It says enter your details within 72 hours of your arrival. If your trip isn't within 72 hours, come back later. So go ahead and enter the country of original departure. On the next page, it asks, is your travel related to any of the following travel purposes? So you want to go through these four items, but for this video, we are going to select no. None of these reasons are why I'm traveling to Canada. Now you're going to select the purpose of your travel. Is it to return to Canada, family reunification, foreign worker, or study for international students? So for the purpose of this video, I'm going to select foreign worker. The next page is about adding other travelers. So if you're traveling with another person, like your spouse, child, or parents, or someone else, you can add them here. If you are traveling alone, you can just click on the blue icon and go to the next page. Now this page is about the traveler's details. You need to select your document type, which is in most of the times passport, country of issue, passport number, full name, and your date of birth. This is where you need to provide your phone number and select your language of choice. Here you need to fill out your proof of vaccination questions. If you have received them, just click yes, and if not, click on no. If you selected yes, you need to enter which COVID vaccine did you receive for your first and second dose. Enter the date, the country you have got them, and upload a photo of your proof of vaccination. This page is about the mandatory travel requirements, so I urge you to read these points and click on I acknowledge. It says individuals 5 years old older should have a proof of molecular test before boarding flights to Canada. Unless exempt, you should have a 14-day quarantine plan. Unless exempt, you need to take a PCR test on arrival and on day 8 as well. So once you read them, click on I acknowledge. Have you tested positive between 14 and 90 days before your departure? No. Do you have a negative test taken no more than 72 hours before your departure? Yes. Which country did you receive your negative test from? A quick tip here, your test results should be in English or French, and if it is in any other language, you need a notarized translation for that. So add your country and click on next. As a traveler coming into Canada, you need to declare all countries you have visited 14 days prior to your entry. So if you have visited any country other than the country you're coming from, you should select yes and enter it. But for the purpose of this video, we are going to select no. So at this stage, we are done with the basic information, and now we have to complete our quarantine plan questionnaire. Do you have accommodation where you can quarantine 14 days or longer? Select yes. Can you avoid all contact with other people in the household? Yes. Will you have access to the necessities of life without leaving your place? Yes. Are there at-risk people at your location, like 65 years old or older, with underlying medical conditions or have a compromised immune system? No. Is there a person at your location who works in a facility, home, or workplace of at-risk population, like nurses or doctors? No. Is your place a group living environment, like a shelter or hostel? Select no. Next, you need to enter your full address and enter your destination type, like returning home. The last step is gonna be self-assessment. Are you or any other travelers experiencing any of the following symptoms, like fever, cough, or difficulty breathing? Select no. And that's it. When you hit the submit button, you acknowledge that everything is correct. Make sure to take a screenshot of your receipt, because you need to show it to the border officers when you arrive in Canada. So if you got value, please hit the like and subscribe if you haven't already. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Cheers.